A senior prison officer has been fined $10,000 for causing the death of an inmate through negligence. Lim Kuo Yin pleaded guilty to causing the death of 21-year-old Dinesh Raman Chinnaya by failing to exercise adequate supervision in September 2010. The 36-year-old could have been jailed up to 2 years.
Lim Kuo Yin, a deputy superintendent in the Singapore Prison Service, was charged on Friday afternoon. He pleaded guilty and was sentenced within the day. The court heard that on the day of the offence at about 10:45 a.m., Dinesh Raman exited his cell and kicked a prison warden in his abdomen. The inmate was restrained according to protocol and brought to the disciplinary housing unit. There, Lim failed to adequately supervise the restraint operation where Dinesh Raman was placed in a prone position on the ground. The position resulted in Dinesh Raman having breathing difficulties. At about 11:18 a.m., Lim re-entered the cell to check and found him to be unresponsive. Medical personnel were called in to start medical aid, but Dinesh Raman did not respond. He was then sent to Changi General Hospital and pronounced dead at 12:45 p.m. In mitigation, Lim's lawyer Wendell Wong told the court that the prison officer takes the life of every inmate seriously. He said Lim is absolutely gutted by the loss of a life and that Lim is profoundly sorry. The lawyer said there's absolutely no motive for Lim to act in a manner which resulted in the loss of a life. Mr. Wong noted that Lim did attempt to look at Dinesh Raman's face, but he admitted his client could have better noticed the inmate's condition. Mr. Wong highlighted that Lim, together with the other wardens, had taken immediate steps to revive the inmate when he realized Dinesh Raman was not responding. In sentencing, District Judge Liu Tiam Leng agreed with most of what the defense had said. But what was clear, said the judge, was that the accused did not adequately observe the acts of restraint, which resulted in the loss of a life. Lim arrived in court accompanied only by his lawyers. Throughout the hearing, he seemed calm and seemed prepared to face the music. Channel News Asia understands that he has been transferred and is now taking up a more administrative role.
Senior Minister of State for Home Affairs Masagos Zulkifli has sent his condolences to the victim's family.
I worked with the prison officers for many years around rehabilitation issues. They work in a very challenging environment, but despite this, they are focused on the noble effort to bring rehabilitation a reality for the prisoners and to ensure that the prisoners, when they come out of prison, will have the best chance to reintegrate in the society. It is indeed regrettable that this incident has happened.
Mr. Masagos also says he expects other prison officers to continue their good work.
Our officers are well trained to handle various situations. Despite the setback, I'm sure they'll pick up and they will continue to work professionally and focus on keeping the prison environment safe and at the same time ensure that the prisoners have the best chance of rehabilitation and reintegrate back into society.
Well, the family of Dinesh Raman say they are upset that Lim Kuo Yin received only a fine, especially when a life was lost. Almost 3 years on, they say they are still not sure exactly how the 21-year-old died. They have not decided if they will take further legal action.
In December 2007, Dinesh Raman was convicted of rioting and theft and sentenced to reformative training. He was released in January 2010. A few months later, he was recalled to Changi Prison Complex for failing to comply with the conditions of his supervision order. His mother, who declined to be named, said she did not know why her son went back to jail. The 47-year-old cleaner last saw him shortly before that. She says that as a mother, it is difficult to think badly of her son. She painted a different picture of him as a boy who was close to his parents, who was affectionate and kind to those he loved, and would help out with the household chores and marketing. She continues to live in the Jurong East flat that they shared with her husband and younger daughter, but admits that it is difficult for her as she is constantly reminded of her son. Even though it's been almost 3 years since he died, not a day goes by when Dinesh's mother does not think about her son. In fact, she still keeps his personal belongings, such as his jeans, his watch, and even his army uniform to remember him by.
The Home Affairs Ministry says a committee of inquiry was appointed in March this year to look into the circumstances surrounding the death of inmate Dinesh Raman. The committee was also asked to recommend improvements to existing systems, protocols and processes. A report was submitted to the ministry last month, and among their recommendations, the need to review training doctrine and better educate prison officers on the risk of positional asphyxiation. They also recommended that prison officers should be kept up to date in first aid skills. Proficiency training should also be conducted regularly to ensure officers are better prepared to handle emergency medical situations. MHA says it accepts the findings and recommendations, while the Singapore Prison Service says it has implemented the suggested improvements.
Currently, there are about 12,000 inmates in the Singapore Prison Service's custody. While acts of indiscipline and violence are not high, they are not uncommon. Just last month, a senior prison officer was stabbed with a pair of scissors by an inmate. In 2012, there were 61 assaults by inmates, the majority against other inmates. The Singapore Prison Service says compared to other countries, this number is low. For example, in the United Kingdom, more than 42 violent incidents happen on a daily basis in the prison institutions. In Singapore, restraint techniques were introduced in the 1990s. They involve 3 to 4 officers employing a set of wrist and arm locks. As a safeguard, one officer in the team is responsible for ensuring the well-being and safety of the officers and the violent subject. Other options like pepper spray and handcuffs are used to complement the techniques. The prison says these techniques have been used hundreds of times and there has been no death or significant injury caused. The Singapore Prison Service says now that the case is concluded, it will assess whether any other actions have to be taken against the officers involved. Deputy Director of Prisons, Mr. Desmond Chin, said the prisons will review its internal processes and will draw lessons from the incident and continue to do their best to uphold the mission of ensuring the safe and secure custody of inmates.